Describes her tits in excruciating detail, plus the old slipping on shit defense, internally blasting problem turds, and furries have creeped out Tony the Tiger once again. All this with your voicemails today!
It's the Distorted View Show with Tim Henson.
Stuff my fucking asshole. That's it. Stuff the fucking shit box.
Yeah, Tim Henson back here with you. I would say to end the week with the Friday show, but I will be back this weekend because, you know, we did a best of show on Wednesday. That reminds me, someone called into the voicemail line and was giving me shit, and I want to take care of this right now. Otherwise, I'll just be in a shitty mood the entire episode. I saw the transcript. I haven't heard. I don't know who sent this in, but I did see that Google Transcripts transcribed it or something.
Hey, Tim, Tony Prolapse.
Oh, Tony Prolapse. All right, what do you have to say, sir?
So I like how you say, for the free side, that you don't take many days off.
I said that. That's right, I probably did say that.
And then, like, a day later, you play a best-of show. Just wanted to throw it out there. And, I mean, go back through the year and see how many best-of shows there are. Don't.
Well, listen. I make up those shows. It's not like I'm taking it off and fucking you guys over. Every time I take a day off, I then do a weekend show. So it's the same amount of new programs a week. Plus, you get a best of show, like an old program you probably never heard anyway.
Don't lie to the freestyles, Tim.
How dare you?
Just tell them, hey, when Timmy gets the sniffles.
But I wasn't sick, is the thing. You heard me introduce the best of show. Also, I posted a video for everyone on YouTube and Facebook and all those stupid things. And then I did another video the next day for Sideshow members. So it's not like I was not doing something. I understand you love your Distorted View daily and you want it when you want it. But sometimes you can't have it.
Fools. 20, 25 times a year, he takes a day off. It's okay.
Again, the majority, that may be true, maybe 20 shows a year that I miss. But, like I said, the majority of the time, they are then made up on the weekend. I noticed in your argument there, you were very selective and you didn't bring that up, how they're all made up on the weekend. So blow it out your fucking prolapsed ass, Tony Prolapse. Again, I get it. You love Distorted View Daily. You need me in your life. It's funny, as I'm saying this, or screaming this, I feel like I'm getting a sore throat. I left the window open and it got so cold. And my voice is getting scratchy. So, look, I do over 200 shows for you every year. Some of those are going to be weekend programs because instead of taking off Sunday, I will take off Wednesday or something, okay? It's kind of how it's always been, and it's how it's always going to be. The only difference is I'm way better now at making up these shows on the weekend. So, again, Tony Prolapse, you've put me in a foul mood. All right, listen, I do have a great program for you today. I know what will cheer me up. Archived racism. Ta-da! Yes, I have got a clip here of a white woman who called police because while she was at a convenience store, she claims a little black boy grabbed her ass. And when I say little, I mean, you know, under the age of puberty. He's got to be like, what, 8, 9, something like that. Also, this woman does not have an ass to grab. She's shaped like a fucking beanpole. By the way, that was my mom's nickname in high school. And she's still very bitter about that. I guess she was like, as a kid, she was very thin and kind of tall for her age. And that's how she got the nickname. I'm not sure if there were any speed bumps along her body. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know if her tits jet out. I honestly don't know what my mom's boob size is. Or I couldn't even give you an idea. I don't know if they're a B. I don't know if they're a D. I've never thought about my mom. I can honestly tell you, I've never thought about my mom's boobs before. I'm kind of curious now what she's packing down there. Let me give her a call. I mean, I'm not trying to be salacious or provocative. I'm genuinely curious because I don't think of my mommy that way. Nor was I allowed to suckle, you know, wrap my hands around that tit meat and slurp on that nourishing nectar. Oh, now she's not going to be home.
You've reached the Hanson residence.
That's my brother.
We're unable to answer the phone now. So please leave a message at the town of the beach.
Mm. You can hear my mom. Patricia, this is your son. If you're home, pick up. Pick up! It's very important. I'm in jail! You need to bust me out! Mom, I can't go to prison! You know what they'll do to me? Oh, there we are. See, I knew you were home. I knew you were home.
I know, yeah. I was just about ready to wash my hair. What's going on?
Listen, you're on my show, and I have a very important question to ask you about your about your tits.
About my what? My tits?
Yes. Well,
God.
I know this is so wrong, but so I was thinking,
yes.
I don't know how I got on the topic. Oh, I know how. When you were in high school or whatever, they called you beanpole, right? Because you were very thin and tall.
Yes, I was.
So, I don't know what your boobs are like. Like, I was thinking about this. Like, I don't know how big. I've never really looked at your boobs. I don't know what you're packing under those tight sweaters you wear, parading around town like a hussy.
I have to tell my son what my boobs look like now? This is sick.
I know. It's so wrong, but come on.
It is. So wrong is right, yes.
This is not for me. This is for my listeners who fantasize about you in an erotic way.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. That's
bad.
That's bad.
I know. Got a bunch of perverts listening to the show. All right, so come on. What do you got down there? So, whip them out.
Mine, I've always had small tits.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, what like a bee?
I was, let's see, well, when I was younger, yeah, well, I was in a B. Now that I got older and they're sagging, they're getting bigger.
Oh, so now are you up to maybe a C now?
Well, I guess I could get into a C, but my problem is one of my boobs is smaller than the other because I had...
A mastectomy? You didn't have a mastectomy.
No.
Oh,
no,
okay.
It wasn't that.
Good.
It wasn't that. It was a cyst. I had cysts. I had some cysts taken out. Uh-huh. I had one when I was like in my 20s or something like that, and then I had another one on the same breast, on the left side. I had the same thing. So when they cut that left boob there a couple times, it made it like a little bit smaller than the right one. So my right one is a little bit bigger. I like my left one better because it's bigger. It's a lot bigger. Not a lot bigger, but it's bigger. Yeah.
Now, Patricia.
Yeah.
I specifically asked you about your boob size because my listeners want to fantasize about you, and now you're telling me about your lumpy, cysty tits.
Oh well, that's what I'm going to get to because the cysts made the bra size smaller.
Right. Okay.
You know what I mean?
Okay.
So. Yeah, so actually, I'm about in a C now.
Okay.
I'm in a BC.
But it's not. Yeah. It's because they're sagging is the reason why. So that's not hot either.
Yeah, well. Yeah, when you get older, you know, they're not perky like they were when you were younger. You
okay,
know? Yeah.
Well, look.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that, but,
oh,
you know.
It's okay. It's not your fault you had cysts on your boobs. So what are you, like a 34, 36?
I was, I was 34B, yeah. So that's about it.
All right.
You guys were never breastfed, so.
I know.
Yeah. I wish now maybe if I did, maybe they would be bigger, huh? You think?
Well, and maybe I'd be smarter. That's what they say, you know?
you're smart.
We're both suffering because of your breasts.
My boob problem, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm sorry that... I'm sorry I had to talk to you about this, especially you, my son.
No,
I'm not supposed to be talking. Yeah.
Well, now
but,
I know.
Anyway. Now you know what's that. Okay. So for Christmas, is that what I'm going to get for Christmas now? A bra?
I think some of my creepo listeners might be sending you some bras.
Oh, I like lace. Tell them I like lacy ones.
Oh, no. For who? For what? What? What are you doing with lacy bra? I don't want to know. That's okay.
Okay.
All right. I will talk to you later. Love you. Bye.
Okay. Okay. Bye-bye.
My mom never hangs up on me. The trick is I never call her on the phone unless it's for my show. Basically, if you want to hear from your son, you'll answer the call and answer all of my questions. Otherwise, you won't see me until Christmas, where I expect a present. Now describe your boobs in detail. I want the shape. Are they lumpy due to cysts? That was too much information. All right. This has nothing to do with the clip I was playing for you, right? I call the woman who's accusing this black boy of sexual assault a beanpole. All right, so here she is. Have we even started this? I don't know.
Cops here right now.
No,
I'll talk to you.
Daddy!
The kids are crying because they think they're going to be going to jail.
Daddy! I'm going to stay right here.
Daddy! Oh, man.
All right. So now here is the woman on the phone.
Yeah, they're videotaping.
Mentally ill.
Yeah.
Mentally
ill.
Listen,
you remember me, right? From school, right?
Yeah. That's right. The sun grabbed my ass.
She said that my
decided to yell at me.
So I'm going to stay right here.
Your security cameras.
Let me go. Don't say no way. Go home.
Let's make it go viral.
Go home. No.
No, not her.
Okay, I would love for this to go viral, but you need to shut the fuck up and let the racist lady talk. I hate, you know, you're filming her talking. Shut your mouth.
No, no.
Come on. She's calling police on a black
woman. Go home. She needs to go home. Don't do this. This woman's stupid.
Now, you're filming this to document the white lady being racist, but everyone starts talking. It's so loud. The white lady is drowned out.
Don't cry, little
one
man.
Voice, no. Two voice, three voice, four, five. Fucking anarchy.
Look at that.
Here's the thing. There are store surveillance cameras, so we know actually what happened. This woman was at the counter, right, checking out. This woman and her kids walked by her. You see the kid, his elbow must have, like, rubbed up against her boob because it was a tight spot. But his hand was, you know, holding something. His hand was in the clear. He wasn't trying to cop a feel or anything. He was just trying to scooch on by. I don't know if this is a case of racism, like Permit Patty. They're calling her Convenience Store Carol or something. But I think this woman actually believes that her ass was grabbed. Now... if you noticed that a, you know, 7-year-old grabbed your ass or brushed up against your ass, would you call the cops? Probably not. This woman's a little nutty.
The little kid bust her ass.
Now, the black crowd that is gathering outside the convenience store is going a little insane by calling her a pedophile. It's like, wait a second, I didn't grab the child's ass. The child grabbed my ass.
Go home!
Pedophile.
Let me go home, you pedophile! You pedophile! Oh, okay. Ah, he said that little boy touched the ass!
Well, something did touch her ass. I mean, he touched her ass, but it was by, you know, it was an accident. Screaming pedophile is not helping anything. We do hear more from the accuser here in a second. Other white people start swooping in to yell at this crazy broad.
And I am going home. Goodbye, 911 operator. Now, why don't you upload that to World Star?
Oh, that's racist.
Hey, what is your problem? I'm calling you out. You seriously just called a police officer.
No white lady, I will not.
Okay, white lady.
Wow, she's really bringing race into this on a lot of fronts. Saying World Star. That was some thinly veiled racism. What, this guy's not going to upload it to YouTube because he's black?
Don't even get involved no more.
Yeah,
don't even get involved no more, miss, because that's...
Oh, shameful. You cannot shame me. You are a child. You are young enough to be my daughter.
So it goes on a little bit longer. Again, as I mentioned, surveillance video shows that the woman's ass was not touched. What you didn't hear, at some point in that phone call, this woman gives out her address. A rookie mistake, because, you know, now the internet has your address. Very bad move. The local news tracked her down, which wasn't very hard, because, she gave out her phone number. There wasn't a lot of investigative work there. They knocked on her door, and I believe she threatened to call the cops on them, too.
What's the response so far? I mean, have people been knocking on your door all night? Did you have to change your phone number?
That's pretty much her standard response. Apparently, this woman lives in a cave.
Okay.
But the video shows the boy was not touching your ass.
Okay.
Do you feel like you're in danger?
Mm-hmm.
Do you want us to leave?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have a cucumber in your mouth?
Yes.
All right, moving on. I have got a freak out here from a woman who's fighting with a guy. I think she found out that he cheated on her, or maybe he owes her money for sex or something. I'm not really sure what's going on. She's a little nuts, though. And there's a third party, a guy who's filming this, and what we learn is this crazy lady is a bit vain, and she will perform for any camera. She immediately gets lured in. She stops what she's doing. You know, she's wailing on this guy she's fighting with, but she sees the camera and then immediately has to talk to the guy.
Okay.
Ooh. She slaps him right in the face.
Ooh.
This is going down at a gas station.
I got you.
Yeah. So she notices the camera. Again, mentions World Star. Racist.
I got you.
Put me on World Star. The little bitch wants to fucking.
Tell the camera.
Okay, now, as this woman is being distracted by the camera, the man that she's fighting with is leaving, but she doesn't notice.
Tell the camera what he did. Tell the camera what he did.
I'm the shit. Ain't no bitch hotter than me. Ain't no bitch more paid than me. Fuck all you fucking bitches.
Therefore.
Fuck all you bitches. Ain't nobody got $10,000 tits like me. $10,000 on my tits, bitch.
Well, my mom had a few cysts removed from her tits. So top that. No, please don't make me do the Teen Witch rap again. Top that. All right, let's finish up here.
$10,000 tits like me. $10,000 on my tits, bitch.
As she's turning around after saying $10,000 titties, bitch, she realizes the guy has left. The guy she was fighting with has fled the scene.
Oh my god, he lost me!
He lost me. She's running down the street.
Ooh, I got it!
That guy is loving it. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. All right, and with that, let's get into the crazy, bizarre, twisted, up the news right now. Yo, Yeah, like I mentioned, yesterday we did a sideshow exclusive program. The day before that was a sideshow exclusive video. And on Tuesday, we did another exclusive program. It's a great time to sign up. You get full access to the entire archive of shows. Plus, every week, you do get all that bonus material in the form of exclusive shows and videos. SuperFreakSideshow.com, that's our address. I've made it very simple for you to sign up. It's only $6.99 a month, even less when you opt for a quarterly, semi-annual, yearly, or lifetime membership. All major credit cards and PayPal accepted. If you like the show, prove it. Support this nonsense. Other ways to support the show, we've got a Patreon account, patreon.com/distortedview. I will be doing a new video for patrons real soon as well. I think I'm going to be showing off my audio setup as well, because some people were asking about that. It's always changing because I'm never happy with things. Hey, before we get into the first story, I do want to mention our YouTube account, because this is fucking depressing as hell. It's mostly my fault. It's a very neglected YouTube channel, youtube.com/distortedview. But now that I'm doing videos again, I'm starting to post there, although no one's watching these videos. We've got like 4.2 thousand subscribers. I would like to see that number double in the next week, please. More importantly, check out the new videos that I'm posting, because exactly 100 people have watched the video I posted yesterday, which is a very sad, sad number. It's almost not worth doing videos for just 100 people to watch. Like, another, I think, 200 saw it on Facebook. But still, it's only 300 people. Those are the type of numbers I make fun of when I'm when I'm playing videos on the show. I'm like, ha ha, only 200 people saw your stupid video, you idiot. You've got bad content. So maybe I have bad content. Maybe it's time for me to pack it up. But yeah, if you're not subscribed to youtube.com/distortedviewshow, smash that subscribe button. And that bell, that's something new too. I mean, new within the last 4 or 5 years since I last posted on YouTube. Apparently you'll only get notifications on YouTube if you hit that bell button. So stupid. YouTube is dumb. I would self-host these videos, but that takes a lot of bandwidth if you want the videos to look nice. It's just better to post them on YouTube. The newest video, by the way, features Waluigi as a woman, illustrated by Level 80 Cat Lady, so you should definitely check that out. I'll provide a link on the show notes today. All right, 3 very quick stories, then we'll get the hell out of here. First up, oh man, I wish you guys would have been in the bathroom with me today when I was taking my midday shit. It actually should have been my morning shit. But I couldn't get into the bathroom this morning, so I waited. And maybe that's what caused my bowel movement to solidify to the point I was pushing like I was giving birth. There were contractions. I was in stirrups. It was a breech birth. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. No, it was just a very hard shit. And I'm not saying like it was hard like a brick. I'm saying like it was hard to shit. It was a difficult shit. And those are the most satisfying when you're done. I mean, when you're going through it, it's hell. Like, I would push and push and push. Like, the shit was coming out of my asshole, but then it kind of got stuck. And it was very hard, like a brick. So sometimes, like, if you get if you're shitting and it's like a big shit and you can't get the whole thing out, sometimes you can stop. Your sphincter will close up and, like, snip off the shit that's already like hanging out of your ass and give you a little bit of relief, and then you can push the rest out afterwards. But this one was so hard, my asshole was wrapped around it, and it was trying to close, but the turd was too hard and it wouldn't pinch off, so I had to just continue pushing. It was touch and go for a while. Wasn't sure if I'd be able to pull through. But man, when it finally dropped off, oh, it was so relieving. So I might be constipated. There's a reason why I'm telling you this. It's related to our first news story. There is a new constipation remedy on the horizon. Like, an entirely new way to deal with the problem of constipation. This is something you don't see very often. It's not just like a new drug, right? This is a new way to stop constipation or relieve constipation. It's not just like, oh, a new brand of enema or a new drug you can take. No, This is a capsule you take, but the capsule does not contain drugs. It's basically a vibrator, a tiny vibrator. And I believe this vibrator shakes violently and breaks up the turds inside of you. It's a shit smasher. It's like mini demolition equipment. Swallowing a vibrating capsule could relieve chronic constipation, research suggests. The medication programmed to vibrate in the large intestine stimulates stomach contractions and helps to move digestion along. Taking the capsule, which is the size of a fish oil supplement, I've tried taking those fish oils. Those are some big-ass pills. Just 5 times a week doubles the number of bowel movements a constipation sufferer has. If larger studies confirm the capsule's safety and effectiveness, the medication could be available in just 3 years' time. It would be awesome if it was Bluetooth-enabled. There's like a little camera in there. You could see what's going on inside of you. Maybe there's a speaker. Could stream my music to my intestines. Play some bass-heavy tunes and really get that shit broken up. That'd be kind of cool. You could feel the music inside of you. So according to the information I have here, the person takes this capsule. You're supposed to take it right before bed. The tablets then vibrate for at least an hour, which you'd think would wake you up, right? If it's inside of you shaking around like a Mexican jumping bean. And they're excreted around 2 days later. I wonder if you have to fish them out. These are very expensive tablets. Dig through your hard poop. All right. So this stimulates stomach contraction, so it doesn't quite break up the poop like I thought it did. It helps to move digestion along. Most of the participants in the trial were unaware of the vibrating sensation. Oh, okay. And suffered no major side effects. Like your asshole didn't fall out or something. The researchers, led by Dr. Satish Rayo, tested the capsule in 2 studies, with a total of 245 people suffering from chronic constipation. The participants took 5 tablets a week for 2 months. Each capsule was taken just before bed. Half the participants were given capsules that contained electric mechanisms that were programmed to vibrate at different frequencies. These tablets, manufactured by the Israeli company Vibrant, I bet you they solely focus on vibrating capsules. Vibrated for either 1 or 2 2.5-hour periods during the 24 hours they were swallowed. They were usually excreted between 1 and 2 days later. The remaining participants took non-vibrating placebos. Results show that participants who took the vibrating capsule had twice as many bowel movements per week as those having the placebo. Constipation affects around 42 million people in the U.S. and 6.5 million people in the U.K. Second story we have for you now. Well, furries, you've done it again. You've driven Tony the Tiger off of Twitter. Because you can't stop tweeting that you want to fuck him. God damn, you are some thirsty bitches. A little over 2 years ago, people were delighted to discover that in the replies to every tweet from Real Tony Tiger, the official Tony Tiger Twitter account, dozens of mascot mad furries could be found begging the serial tiger for sex. With tweets like, at Real Tony Tiger, fist me, Tony, I love you. Now, Tony replied, or he didn't reply to this the fisting tweet directly, but he did write, I'm all for showing your stripes, feathers, etc., but let's keep things great and family-friendly if you could. Cubs could be watching. As if little children are on Twitter reading tweets at Tony Tiger. I mean, it's possible, but, you know, I think kids have better things to do. Minecraft videos to watch. At some point over the past few months, the at Real Tony Tiger account disappeared. The URL now leads only to an error message. The question is, why? Why did Tony leave Twitter? This is a very in-depth report, by the way, from the Huffington Post. Some awesome, hard-hitting journalism. As recently as May 6, 2018, Tony the Tiger was still tweeting as at Real Tony Tiger. Like, the last thing he tweeted himself was kind of homoerotic. It was him and a guy on a tandem bicycle. To be fair, there is a little baby in a baby seat on the very back of the bike, but it just looks like two gay dads having a fun day out with their kid. It is weird. I mean, I guess I can post this. I'll make it today's featured image so you can see Tony the Tiger bicycling. Kellogg's Frosted Flakes hasn't abandoned Twitter altogether. They're still at Frosted_Flakes, and they also posted that Tony the Tiger picture. Sometime, though, between May and September, Tony left the internet. You can still find mentions of the Twitter account, and therein lies the problem. There were tweets like this on July 8th, 2018. At Boo Lovely Day tweeted, "Fill me up with your Frosted Flakes, Daddy." At Ryan Socko 3 says, "Tony, please put your whiskers in my ass." Wild Wolf Tunes tweeted, "Hey, Mr. Tony the Tiger, are your flakes frosted? I just want to suck your dick, please." And Hawk Babble said, "Tony, I don't need your flakes. I just want your delicious love, your milk and sweet frosting inside my mouth. Could you do that for me, Daddy? That would be great." Now, we've read about Tony the Tiger's Twitter account on DV before. The furries have been harassing him for years now. Last year, Tony restricted his tweeting to straightforward customer service replies dealing with concerned or unsatisfied customers. That last tweet, though, the picture of him on a bicycle with another dude, that garnered some attention from furries as well. Like Scorpion Boy, who said, "Would you invite me, Daddy, on a bike ride and teach me how to ride you?" The furriest of furries said, "Can you show me how to ride on you?" My personal favorite, Rape Face Breakson, tweeted, "Those thighs, that sweet booty snap, I want to yiff it all off!" Very flattering, Rape Face. And finally, Heidi Turner says, "Frost my ass, Dad." And then a bunch of, like, wet emojis. The article ends with, "It appears that a Tony-centric Twitter just wasn't worth being asked to, quote, please frost my flakes, Daddy, 100 times a day. That's probably why the Twitter account was pulled. Final story we have for you today. Oh, this is great. We end the day with a story from our most fucked up state. Say it with me.
Our most fucked up state.
A 38-year-old Lakeland woman said she accidentally stabbed her husband to death because she tripped while holding a kitchen knife. That's gotta be one of the most overused defenses, right? She fell, knife first, into his back, Your Honor. She's very clumsy. Look at this broad. She's ditzy. Wearing those high-heel fuck-me shoes. Not paying attention. You know how women are. All right, the Polk County Sheriff's Office doesn't buy her story. That's like the equivalent to, "My dog ate my homework." Everyone uses this defense. All right, so they don't believe her. She was arrested Wednesday on October 10th after the medical examiner ruled the June 25th death of Brian Fidinian, 40, a homicide. Oh, I'm going to have to keep saying that last name, aren't I? Fidinian called 911. I'm like 99.9% sure I'm mispronouncing that. Fidinian called 911 on June 25th to report that she'd accidentally stabbed her husband. She told the 911 dispatcher that she was using a kitchen knife to slice pizza. She got confused. "He's got a lot of zits on his back. If you squint, it kind of looks like pizza." All right. She was using a kitchen knife to slice a pizza when she heard her dog whimper. She is going to blame the dog. She said she looked over and saw that the dog was peeing and pooping on the floor. She rushed to pick up the dog, and her husband came forward to help her at the same time. She said that's when she tripped on an area rug. Did she slip on the piss and shit? And stabbed her husband. He was taken to the hospital where he died of his injuries. Early in the investigation, detectives said they were suspicious of Fidinian's story. She said she was wearing a black and red flannel robe when the stabbing occurred. But the robe showed no traces of urine or feces. The plot thickens. Detective said the demonstration Fidinian gave of how she was holding the knife as she tripped to pick up the dog and ended up stabbing her husband didn't make much sense. It was the medical examiner's conclusion that the death was a homicide that gave detectives probable cause to arrest her this week. According to the autopsy, the husband died when 4 inches of the knife blade sliced through his second rib bone. Yeah, there was some force involved there, and severed the pulmonary artery that supplies blood to the heart, which is something you need to live, I think. The suspect made a lot of excuses, but none of them made sense, said Polk County Sheriff Grady Judd. Our detectives did a thorough investigation. In the end, they determined this was an intentional act of domestic violence. She's being held without bail at the Polk County Jail. So there you go. That, my friends, is your distorted news for Friday. Let's do a couple voicemails and get the hell out of here. I love to hear from you freaks. If you want to hear your voice on this program, call into our voicemail line, 206-666-4463. I will play your call. I'm a little behind. I'm about a month behind on calls. If you want to hear your call soon, like in the next day or two, call into our Patreon exclusive line. You just got to pledge a few dollars over there. Patreon.com/distortedview. I play all those calls first. Other ways to contact me, show@distortedview.com. We've got a post office box address if you have something you want to send to me in a physical kind of way. And, of course, check me out on social media, @distortedview on Twitter and Instagram, facebook.com/distortedviewshow. And, of course, very important, youtube.com/distortedviewshow. If you want me to do more videos, you gotta watch these fucking things. I do them for you, not for me. It drives me up the fucking wall.
Hey, Tim. Just listen to the October 11th show. You're talking about that person who had the, was it the emotional support squirrel on the airplane?
Yeah.
So, the obvious...
That was yesterday's Sideshow exclusive program. A woman had an emotional support squirrel. It caused quite a ruckus on a plane.
So, the obvious question here is, what emotional support animal would you want? Because, you know, remember, you had that car accident, so...
Oh, that's right. I've suffered PTSD.
Tim, I think you need...
Could I get on some sort of, like, government assistance? Like, could I get, like, a monthly stipend or something? I can't work.
I think you need some help.
I do, too.
And I think that it would be...
traumatic.
...totally wrong for people to deny you the emotional support that you need.
I want... Are ocelots a thing?
At this time.
Or are they extinct? So ocelots are a thing, right? They're
like
cats. We've
got to pick out an animal for you.
Let me see.
And I think we need... I don't know what animal would be good, but I think we've got to have some kind of animal that has, like, a huge...
dick?
Really obnoxiously visible erection.
Yeah.
Like, all the time.
Yeah, I definitely don't want to get my service animal neutered.
Obnoxiously visible erection. Like, all the time.
Can I get, like, one of those ponies? One of those, like, real tiny ponies, those Shetland ponies?
You know, so you're walking around to the bank, you know, and everything. And...
I want a Shetland pony with a stallion's dick.
Something like that. Huh.
Yeah, I'll look into that. By the way, I was doing a search for ocelots just to see what they look like. They look pretty much like I thought. But the first... You type in ocelot, and Google wants to autofill some, you know, potential searches. The second one is ocelot pet. So there are a lot of people wanting ocelots as pets. I guess it's not as uncommon as I thought. Like, I'm thinking of, like a fucking puma or something. Like, that's what I want as a pet. But like many wild cats, ocelots are occasionally kept as pets. Salvador Dali frequently traveled with his pet ocelot, Babu, or something. Let me look up ocelot support support animal. See if we can get a trained ocelot for my PTSD. Nothing comes up, unfortunately, on Google. There's got to be someone who will train an ocelot for me. All right, next up here.
Hello, I'm Zanovich, Vladimir Putin. I called into the chat line as Vladery.
Hello. Hey, Tim. Hey, it's me. I'm not sure I use the 206 line to leave message.
That is pretty amazing.
As it is more controllable, I have buttons to push, but it's just easier to connect and merge the calls on this line than the Patreon line here. So please review the call. I don't know if it was very good. It was with a lady who said she could see devils in men and was no longer a very strange lady, but I don't really feel like the call was that great. But listen to it, review it, see what you think. Play a bit. I don't know. It wasn't as good as my first one.
I love his accent. His Russian accent is kind of fading in and out.
Was that great? But listen to it, review it, see what you think.
Right here.
Play a bit. I don't know. It wasn't as good as my first one. It's tough. It's tough, right? It's like it's like that first call. I thought it went really well.
That's coming back.
So now I feel a little. It's kind of like when you an author writes their first book and it's really good and it gets good reception. The second one's going.
For those of you that don't remember, apparently the person Vladimir Putin put on a female voice called into the chat line. I was going to do that today. I forgot to. Then I got sidetracked by talking to my mom. But hey, we'll do that next week. Maybe I'll call into the party line chat thing. Anyway, that's what Vladimir Putin did. What, about a month or two ago? And called into the voicemail line while he was on the party line, and it produced some great audio. So apparently he did that again. Maybe I'll try to track down that audio and play it for you tomorrow on the weekend show, or Sunday, whenever I do the weekend show.
What did I hear? Corey's wife? What? Corey not gay? What? Oh, maybe his wife is tranny.
I don't know what that means. We were talking about Corey. Corey from Buttfudge Sunday posted something on Facebook. It was, I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to get him in trouble. Go back and listen to the Sideshow exclusive program. That is all the time we have on this edition of the show. Want you guys to email me, show@distortedview.com. Distortedview.com is our official website. Voicemail line for you, 206-666-4463. That's 206-660-GOD. Is it? Oh God.
Ain't nobody got 10,000 art tits like me.
And no, Corey is not gay. Is that what some of you people thought? Corey was gay? I can see that. See where there would be some confusion there. No, he is married. Spread the distortion, STD. Tell all your friends about the podcast. Don't forget to rate us and review us on iTunes. Check out our YouTube videos, youtube.com/distortedview show. I will see you back this weekend for a WEEKEND show. Until then, have a great day. Bye, everybody. I love you.
Breast cancer is the leading cause of cancer-related death among women, second only to lung cancer. Early detection, before it spreads, is essential to survival.
There is a big, kind of golf ball-sized lump.
She's up, she's up, she's in my
breast.
She's up, she's up, she might be dead.
I see dead people.
There was a large lump at the left side of the left breast.
Life's a bitch, and then you die.
And the whole talk now is about breast cancer. You're gonna die when God tells you to die.
She's love, she's love, she's in my
breast.
You're beautiful when you're dying.
She's love, she's love, she's love, she might be dead.
Hearing the doctor say you have breast cancer, I mean, that's like a punch in the gut.
So in order for me to really inspect the tissue, I'm going to have you lower your gown to your waist. Go all the way around the breast tissue, feeling for any lumps, lesions, fibrotic tissue, tenderness.
I have never been as excited as I am right now.
All the way around until we get to the nipple.
Holy cow.
Good. Everything appears to be healthy and normal.
A Florida man is in jail after going door-to-door offering free breast exams. 76-year-old William Winnicott carried a doctor's bag and said the exam would be a good idea to prevent breast cancer. Police now want to know if other women were tricked.
She's loved, she's loved, she's in my
breast.
Die, bitch.
She's loved, she's loved, she's loved, she might be dead.
At first, I didn't want to buy another pair of shoes. I thought, I'm going to die.
Is this love out of my
breast?
Un-American cancer. You are. You're cancer to this country.
Breast.
I thought it was really interesting that I have this big breaking lump.
Breast.
I have to have another mastectomy.
Ooh, that's gonna leave a mark.
Breast. Cut that bitch out!